Hi, I'm Srinivas. I work on problems related to wireless communication systems in general, and most of my PhD work has been focused on underwater acoustic communications. Let me first briefly give you an overview of what I do, and then I'll talk about some specific problems that I've been working on. So the big picture goal of our work and my group's work is to deploy an acoustic signaling-based underwater sensor network that will help in real-time monitoring of several underwater events of typical interest in life. For example, there's a tsunami or something has happened in the water, there's a target to be detected, and we would like to deploy a network to enable detection of these events in real time. And to enable this, there are several research objectives, and first thing is to design a robust point-to-point communication system. So you have two nodes you want to communicate robustly, and then once you have a network deployed, you want to be able to collect data in real time. So we are working on planning and coordination and control for autonomous underwater vehicles as well. So next, because an underwater network is very geographically spaced, it's very unlikely that all nodes would typically communicate with each other. So we would like to study the problem of cooperation in wireless networks, so which will sort of enable everybody to communicate with each other in some kind of synchronous or asynchronous fashion. So we would like to understand the benefits of cooperation in wireless networks, especially in some kind of limited connectivity environments. I was an intern at Microsoft Research for some time, and we worked on the design of a flexible Wi-Fi system where you can sort of vary the bandwidth and the number of users parallelly connecting. And this would be a full duplex system, and we hope that this will sort of replace whatever is coming up in the Wi-Fi standard next. So let me briefly talk about my research problem. There are several applications for underwater communication systems, both civilian and military. In terms of the military, for example, a submarine could use it to control torpedoes or autonomous vehicles that it has launched and want to survey an area. In terms of civilian applications, you have things like tsunami detection, or you want to monitor an environment, or you want to, say, do a video recording of an oil spill, for example. So there are several applications. And the main challenge to doing this in an underwater channel is basically the problem of Doppler. If you have things moving in water, and because we use acoustic signaling instead of typical radio signaling, there's several problems that come up. The Doppler effect is huge, and this can be seen in the following picture below. So the signal at the receiver is arriving at three different paths, and you can see that the signal duration is scaled by very different amounts. And this is due to the variable Doppler effect, and this causes time-varying interference support. This is not a kind of channel which you typically see in wireless systems, and that is why this problem is very challenging. So this kind of variable packet length sort of translates into the following problem. Whereas in typical wireless systems that we see in radio systems, you have a signaling that is uniform in both time and frequency. In acoustic systems, we have signaling that is geometrically uniform. No, it's not arithmetically uniform. So what you typically learn in wireless, you cannot directly apply to underwater. You have to tune them, you have to modify them, you have to redesign them completely. So most of my research is sort of focused towards building up communication systems from ground up for wideband signaling systems to take into account the geometrical uniform sampling. So let me talk about the three main receiver components for a point-to-point link. So because there is this huge Doppler, and this is a picture which shows the different Doppler rates for each path, you want to figure out a way to optimally compensate for Doppler in the front-end processing. This front-end processing should enable you to, say, reduce the load on further blocks in the system. So we have come up with a way to optimally characterize what is the optimal sampling factor, and we have proposed analysis for this, and we have come up with an algorithm to estimate the correction factor from real-time packet data. Okay, so and underwater channels are typically sparse, which means that the delay spread is huge, but there's only very few paths available. So we are coming up with channel estimation algorithms for this problem. And for the data detection part, we have come up with a new receiver design algorithm that will compensate for much, much more interference what typical wireless equalizer would do. A wireless equalizer would do banded equalization, but we could do band plus multiple several bands as well. And this we have received a provisional patent, and we're filing for a patent as well. Thank you very much.